Here we are, London, the one and only capital city of the United Kingdom of Great Britain and Northern Ireland. I've already made a fucking error and accidentally got on the wrong train. Oopsies. So I'm going on an unexpected trip to London Bridge, which I've actually never seen before, so I'm not too bothered, to be honest. Yeah, I'll be fine. Totally gonna survive in Romania. A wee bit for the vlog. As you guys will have seen in my carefully curated footage, I finally finished my bucket list of London tourist attractions, so all I had left to see was London Bridge and the Shard, and oh my god, they were both so disappointing. I mean, to be honest, I'd kind of lost all hope in like enjoying London tourist attractions when I saw Buckingham Palace. 0 out of 10, do not recommend, it's so underwhelming. The Shard, I mean, it's a kind of cool building, I guess. Like, I like glass, you know, glasswork can be really artistic. But it was just, it was a lot smaller than I thought it would be. And I was just sort of looking at it, I was just like, is that it? And then I went along to London Bridge and I did the sort of walk along, like, the viewing point on the other side of the Thames, so you can, like, see the bridge. And like I was pretty sure, like I knew what it was like right away because I knew obviously what London Bridge should look like the shape of it and stuff. And I was just like, is this it? Is that it? Like, because it took me quite a while to find it as well actually, because it wasn't as close to the train station as I thought it would be. But I don't know, I was just really disappointed. So I guess that's me seeing all the London tourist attractions now that I'd want to see. And yeah, it's all right, it's not terrible, but not gonna lie, the Thames is pretty fucking dirty. So it's not a clean river whatsoever. Also, at this point, I've not slept in, I don't know, maybe like 28, 29 hours. Just, it's not that I don't feel tired, it's just it sort of comes in waves and then I just like have a lot of other things to do and I can't really focus on sleeping. I just did my passenger locator form and I actually had to do it twice because I got emailed literally like half an hour ago from the accommodation supposed to be checking into like tomorrow afternoon saying, oh, the apartment above us has had a leak so we can't accommodate you anymore. And I was like, what the fuck, what am I supposed to do? Like, luckily I managed to get like a full refund and stuff. I'm pretty sure it was a full refund anyway, I can't remember the exact number of lei that it cost me, but I think I've managed to book something else. It also seems to be in like a good central location, so thank God for that. But I couldn't remove my old passenger locator form from my COVID documents on the Ryanair check-in thing. So like, I don't really know how that's going to work and I hope that I'm not going to be like penalised for that. I was so glad to get my negative PCR result this afternoon. I was really freaking out about that. And to be honest, I wasn't really expecting to receive it until like around 10 p.m. tonight, which is when they said like it should be in for. But no, I got it after about 24 hours after getting the test done, so it's pretty good actually. Still not really worth £80, but you know, it's a big, big weight like off my shoulders to know that I'm negative and that I don't need to quarantine, because that really, really suck. Good morning, everyone. Well, I say morning, it's only morning because I've had a little bit of sleep finally. Slept for maybe like 3 hours, and then I was woken up by Lauren's cats meowing very loudly, so great. And then now I'm not sure if I will sleep again before I go away. Maybe. Right now I'm just finally consolidating my vocab from my Romanian lesson last night. Couldn't do it last night because Discord went down, so getting that done, and hopefully I'll remember more stuff. I'm hoping by the end of my trip to be like a bit closer to like A1 level. I know it's quite ambitious, but we'll see. So a bunch of us have been having a little chat upstairs, just to sort of blethering, drank a tiny bit. I had some cava, and they're like smoking and chatting and stuff. It's just vibes, to be honest. It's like about 10 past midnight now, and I have to leave here at 5 a.m. So it's unlikely really that I'm going to get any decent sleep before I go to the airport. I'm just kind of too like buzzing, too excited anyway. I had to have a little bath right now and take some medication, and that's me pretty much sorted, I think. The main thing, like the most pressing issue that I need to do, like when I get into Romania and get to my apartment, is that I need to get a towel, because there's not enough room in my luggage for a towel. But like, Romania has shops, okay? They're not a third world country, so like I'll definitely be able to walk into like, what's it called, like Magic Image or something like that? Mega Image? I think it's Mega Image. They said it's like a Tesco, and they said I should be able to get a towel there, so. Friends! The most depressing thing about going abroad, like, since I got really sick, is that I've got to take, like, a million fucking tablets with me. So I arrived in Romania, I made it to my accommodation. Luckily I met this like really cool guy on the plane who is from Romania, and he ended up like basically helping me get here. Like, his friend drives a taxi, so I got like a free taxi ride from the airport all the way to my accommodation, and like that is based on a whole new level of fucking based, is all I can say. And the apartment's quite nice. I'll do a little tour. Just need to get stuff sorted. I think I'm gonna have a little sleep soon as well, because I'm fucking knackered. I nearly slept on the plane like twice, but like the guy was like talking to me, and I didn't want to like be too rude, so. But yeah, I'm also gonna go exploring soon. I need to get some food in, and I also need to buy a towel. But I saw the Mega Image, so. Which is apparently like the Tesco thing, so I just need. So here we have my charger plugged in, and my luggage, and my bag, and a nice window, and r/TV too high, definitely. And then like through there's like the bathroom, and then it's just like a hallway. And there's also a wardrobe with nothing in it. And then there's this thing, which I thought was a second wardrobe, but it's actually like the kitchenette. Like, it's not even really a kitchenette. It's got a fridge and a sink and like two plates. What a kettle. Pot noodles it is, I guess. And I also have some, like a glass and two mugs and some interesting looking tea.
But yeah, I like it here so far. It's pretty based.
Good morning. Oh, I actually wanted to get up a little bit earlier than this. It's like 9:10 right now. But I was a little bit sleepy. As I've written, I didn't really sleep much for the past couple of days because I was just so excited and like adrenaline pumped for traveling. But now, oh sorry. Oh, but now that I'm here, I'm like, you know, sort of calming back into like a normal, well, normal for me, circadian rhythm. So yeah, I'm planning to like explore quite a lot today. To make sure that Google Maps is working okay, because I don't want to get lost. But I'm sure it'll be okay. Because my sort of survival instinct works a bit more when I'm abroad. I'm also better at like orienteering in other countries for some reason than I am in the UK. Like, I absolutely suck at finding my way in London. Like, it's so bad. I also really like London very much. But so far, I absolutely love Romania. It is lovely. I've not done too much. I went shopping last night and I was told very firmly by all my Romanian friends, like, oh, don't worry, like, if people can see you're struggling, then, like, they'll probably, like, try and talk to you in English and blah, blah, blah. No. Right? So I went to the shop and it was quite late. What was it? Maybe it was, like, 8 p.m. or something. They'd already shut, like, half the lanes in the supermarket, but I wasn't really sure, like, what was going on, because people were like not putting their stuff on the checkout thing like the way that you would in the UK, so I was a bit confused. And also, so I actually went to one of the like closed checkouts first, and then the woman was like talking to me, just like a solid stream of Romanian, and I was just like, duh. I was pretty sure she was telling me that the lane was shut, but I couldn't pick out any words that she said. And then I was in like the next queue that was open, and I sort of accidentally, well, I didn't really bump into this woman, but I was like a little bit in her way, and then I must have looked really confused or something, because she just like gave me this like really, like she started talking to me as well in Romanian, and it's like she was asking me a question, because she was like raising what she said, like raising an inflection at the end of the word, and then also she was sort of looking at me like she expected an answer, and I just had to tell her like no insight, which means like I don't understand. And then like people were looking at me like I was like a proper idiot, but like I don't think that they meant that, because you know it's not really that common for someone from the UK to speak like fluent Romanian. So and then I thought I'd be okay when I got to like the actual bit of like paying for my shopping. So I was waiting like for like the word that I knew for bag, right? And then the guy said something else, so I didn't know what he meant. And he just sort of like whipped out a bag, and he was just like in my face, and I was just like, oh right, duh. It's just like, yeah. Then he like gave me it and I packed my shopping. He told me the price, and like I know numbers, right? And it was a 26, which is a 26 shishasu, and I was just like, I was waiting to hear like a number that I knew, but he didn't say it in a way that I knew, so I was really confused. And he had to like show me on the screen thing how much it was, and I was like, oh god, like such a filthy monolingual right now. And then I went back to my apartment, which I actually walked past initially on the way home. Oops. But then I was just orienteering from memory, like I didn't look on maps until like I had to, which quite fair enough. Because I basically just walked in a straight line up to the supermarket, maybe like a 15-minute walk. And then I went in my like Discord of Romanian people, and I was like, look, like I swear to God, he didn't say like the number 26 the way that I know it.
And they were just like, oh yeah, you probably didn't say it properly. Like, you probably just said it like fast and like cut it a little bit. Like, you know how sometimes we in English, like, we don't say something properly, we say like a shortened version of it. Just like, you probably said something like that, and I was just like, oh my god, why? Like, how am I ever gonna learn?
Not feeling so hungry, so I've got these lime biscuit things for my breakfast. Apparently Romania is fucking full of pigeons as well. Love it. Feel like I'm at home. Just had the most, well, another embarrassing shopping experience. I went to get a ciorbă de pirșoare, which is like a sour soup with meatballs. What was that pronunciation? It's like, looking back at the way that I used to say some things, I can understand how people didn't understand me. I mean, my pronunciation is still not amazing, but... yeah. Oh, in case you didn't know, this is obviously future me editing. It's for my breakfast, and oh god, the ladies in the shop didn't speak English, and they were speaking to me like one word every 3 seconds in Romanian, but I still didn't know the words, so I still had no fucking idea what they were saying. So I just had to sort of worm my way through it and ask what I wanted and say please, and that was about it. It's good though, I still love it here. Need to figure out the way home because I think I might have taken a wrong turn. Love that. I was told that it's like really cold in Romania right now, but that was a big fucking lie because the weather is so nice. It's so mild. I swear to god, it's so much colder in Scotland right now, so I'm loving life. Loving life. And yes, I did take a wrong turn, so I'm currently Google mapping my way back. But Google Maps is taking me a different way from the way that I walked. I guess it's like a faster way. So yeah, I'm just sort of meandering, exploring. Hopefully I'll make it back alive. Should do.
Absolutely shattered. I had the best day. As you guys will have seen, around, I think like around 5-6 p.m. I had some food in this like really popular sort of bar pub type place called Caro de Bere, I think it was. And it means like carriage, I think it's actually, it was Caro Cobere, and that means carriage with beer. Yeah, so that's interesting. And they mean like a like horse carriage, because I think in some areas of Romania they still have like horses and carts, which is like so cool. It's apparently like going back in time in some of those like villages and stuff, but I'm not visiting any of those, I don't think. And I had like this really really nice food, and oh, it was just so good. I ordered my meal in Romanian, but like the waiter kind of like spoke back to me in English because I think he like thought I didn't speak very well, which I don't. I've not been learning that long. But then I asked for the bill in Romanian as well from a different waiter, and he didn't understand what I said. But like, I'm fairly sure that I said it fine because I went in my Discord with my Romanian friends like later, and I was like, okay, I'm gonna send a voice note of me saying this, and you guys can tell me if it sounds strange. So I did, and they were like, no, that sounds fine, it's perfectly understandable. Like, there was something wrong with that guy, and I was like, oh, I don't know. To be fair though, like, the place was so, so busy. Like, it's kind of like a bit of a tourist trap, I think, because the menu is, like, dual language as well. It's written in, like, Romanian and English, which is obviously, like, useful. Hopefully, I'm grateful for it, but You know, I do wish that I spoke Romanian better, but, you know, it'll come with time. Like, you don't become fluent in 3 weeks. Like, it just doesn't happen. Finally ready for the day. I decided to change my jumper today. Oh, God. I couldn't sleep like at all last night. I was up till, I think, like 7:30 in the morning. And then I fell asleep, and I think I slept till like 12 or something like that, but like still in like little bits. I've got some sort of like adrenaline rush thing again. Not ideal, but like, oh well, I'm way to go find this street that's apparently like really, really beautiful, called Calle Victoria. So yeah, excited for that.
Thank you.
future me again. So that was a really beautiful art museum that I went to. I honestly can't remember the name of it, and I'm like so annoyed that I can't remember it. Like, I'm pretty sure I could find it again the next time I go to Bucharest, but oh, I just wish I knew the name of it so I could like put it on. But I mean, maybe one of my Romanian friends will know, and you can pop it down below. I really should have taken note of that, but I was just sort of, well, my heart was like palpitating a bit because I had to speak Romanian when I was in there. Remember, this was back when I'd only been learning for like a couple of weeks, so I didn't really know what to say, and like, I was quite nervous. I still get nervous when I have to speak. It's something I really need to work on. But yeah, it was brilliant, brilliant. Apologies for the towel, I just wanted to get this little story out before I forgot about it. So I went to this pub last night. It's supposed to be like a German themed pub, but it definitely wasn't. It was called Oktoberfest pub or something, so I thought that was going to be like a mega tourist trap, right? Because it isn't like the really touristy part of town, and even when I was walking to it, there was this like bar that was way less busy, and like some guy like approached me in English, obviously thought I looked UK as fuck, and was like, oh, do you want to come in for a drink? And I was like, no, it's okay, I'm gonna look for like a food place. And oh my god, I didn't even get food, because when I went to the pub, like, they didn't understand me, and like, I wasn't even speaking English, I was speaking Romanian, and they were still like, oh, we don't understand, like, oh, we don't speak English. And I was like, I'm not speaking English though, like, listen. My friend was like, oh, they probably just hear a foreign accent and assume that you're not speaking Romanian, because like, you know, very, I mean, obviously there's lots of Romanian language learners, I know lots, but in general, it's not really usual for someone to have Romanian as a second language, so, oh, wellsies. So that wasn't very good, and they spent like half an hour trying to like mime and like explain what stuff on the menu was for me, because they couldn't speak English really either. And I was like, no, like, I can read the menu, like, I know what it says. I just, like, want a minute to decide, but I didn't know how to say that. So I was saying, like, ogliba varok, which is, like, a moment, please, which is what, I guess I say something like that in English, like, wait a minute sort of thing. But apparently, like, in Romanian, that means, like, wait a second. So, like, they just sort of stood, like, looking at me expectedly. I think they understood some of what I said, and I went out for a little bit with one of the guys who I ended up talking to, and he didn't speak very much English, but he spoke it a little bit better than his friend, who was like speaking to me initially. And he was able to understand me like mostly when I spoke Romanian, except from when I make, there's like a certain letter, it actually is like represented by two letters, but it's the same letter, because like it looks like an I with a triangle if it's at the start or end of a word, and like an A with a triangle if it's in the middle of a word. I'd say triangle, it's like a hat. I think they call it a roof or something like that, in like teaching Romanian terms, I don't know. And it's like pronounced like but I can't really say it. So when I'm saying words, it sounds like I'm just saying like how they pronounce the letter U. So yeah, I think when I say words that have that, I can understand why it's a bit harder to understand me, but with other words, like, I don't understand why I'm not being understood, because my friends tell me that I sound fine, so I don't know.
God, I still can't say that letter. If I'm saying it on its own, I definitely can't say it, but I think there's some words that I say where it comes out okay. Like, when I say my untai, which means firstly, I think it sounds okay there, I think. But the majority of the time I can't really pronounce it. If it's at the start of words, sometimes I can sort of like not quite say it and people still know what I mean.
Like in the word Nzileg, which has the letter at the start, so now they just say it like Nzileg. People still know what I mean. Although I was shouted at by one of my friends for doing that. They were like, no, that sounds really stupid, like makes you look uneducated, and I was like, soz. I was recommended by someone on Discord to come to this park. It's like the King Mihai the First Park or something like that. So, I mean, right now all I can see is like grass and trees, but I'm sure there'll be something more interesting a bit further on, hopefully. I almost don't want to sit on the Bucharest bench. Okay, I have found what I came here for. It's this like body of water that I'll show you in just a few seconds. And I actually think it's frozen over. Like, probably not completely, like I'm not gonna go stand on it, but yeah, it's really interesting. Really pretty as well, like reflecting the blue of the sky. Beautiful. It's quite cold though. I wish I brought my gloves with me, but they're in my bag in the apartment, I think. Attractions that I really wanted to see. It's kind of like in the middle of a roundabout, in the middle of a road. It's the Arc de Triumph for Romania. So it's like a war memorial type thing. And oh god, it's so beautiful. It's so fucking big as well. Because I think I saw it from like a bit further away when I was in the park. But like, oh my god, it's so fucking giant. Like I struggled to get a decent picture of it because it's just so big. But yeah, beautiful. Love it. Got me a Chinese for my lunch. Here it is, it looks so good. It's like some sort of spicy beef and rice thing. God, I feel like I'm platchy Simonunk right now.
You too? I'm quite Chinese.
Yeah.
Why?
Vlogging. Che?
Yeah.
So I actually initially wasn't going to split the vlogs. I was going to keep everything together, like my whole time in Romania. But then I was like, you know what, that'd be a really long fucking video for someone to watch. And this is already like half an hour, I think. So I decided to just end it after like my first 4 days, which were in Bucharest. And after this, you'll just see a little couple of clips, just like nothing crazy, just a few wee clips from a little sort of, not quite a house party, but kind of, that I had the night before I went to Brasov, and oh my god. I didn't get like drunk, but I kind of went a little bit further than I should have. So like getting up the next day was not easy. Anyway, right, catch you in the Brasov vlog. For the fucking vlog.